Hello everyone, welcome to Chem9 lab session. This week we will conduct experiment number 11. This experiment deals with acids, bases, pH and buffers. In this experiment there are three sections. In first section, we will determine the pH value of various acids and bases with two different methods. In second section of this experiment, we will learn what happens to the pH of buffers if we add small quantities of acids and bases to it. And finally, and the most important part of this experiment is the acid-base titration. So as usual, the experimental procedure and other instructions are given in this PDF file given in this first tab. Let's click on it and take a look at the instructions. As we have already learned about acids and bases in our lecture session, so we know that acids are those substances which produce or give hydronium ion in water. On the other hand, bases are those substances which release hydroxide ions in water. We also learned about the dissociation constant of pure water, or KW. KW is equals to the product of concentration of hydronium ion and concentration of hydroxide ion. The value of KW is 1.0 times 10 to the negative 14 at 25 degrees Celsius. I would like to mention here that there is a typing mistake or error. This is incorrect here. The value should be 10 to the negative 14, not positive 14. We also learned that pH of any acid can be calculated by this formula. pH is equals to negative log of H positive ion concentration. So if we know the concentration of H positive ion or hydronium ion, we can calculate the pH using this formula. The pH of any solution ranges from 0 to 14. The middle of this value, which is 7, that is the neutral point. So any solution which has pH value of 7 will be neutral. Any value less than 7, the solution will be an acid, and if a solution has pH value anywhere between 7 to 14, then the solution will be classified as a base. So pH value less than 7, solution is acidic. pH value more than 7, solution is basic, and at 7, the solution is neutral. We also learned about buffers. So in short, the buffers are those solutions whose pH is resistant to addition of any acids and bases, or in other words, the pH value of any buffer does not change if we add small quantities of acids or bases to it. There are different kind of buffers, and various buffers may have a low pH or high pH, but the unique property of buffers is that their pH value will not change if we add acids and bases to it. In today's experiment, we will conduct an experiment in which we will take a buffer and we will add acid, and we'll measure its pH value and see what happens to its pH. Does it really remain constant, or does it change? And finally, the third part of today's experiment is acid-base titration. So acid-base titration is an experiment in which we conduct a neutralization reaction between an acid and base. In this experiment, if we have an unknown concentration of an acid, we can measure that unknown concentration by reacting with a base whose concentration is already known. Let me explain this principle in detail. So acid-base titration experiment is based on on the neutralization reaction between an acid and a base. For example, if we react HCl, which is one of the common acid, with sodium hydroxide, which is one of the common base, the product will be water and salt. In this case, the salt is sodium chloride. So this kind of reaction is known as neutralization reaction. Now, if we take a look at this equation, we'll see that this equation is already balanced. So in other words, from this equation, we can say that 1 mole of acid will need 1 mole of base. So that mole ratio to neutralize neutralize any acid and any base can be calculated from the balance equation. So in this acid base equation, as we can see, is already balanced. So 1 here and 1 here, so we can say that 1 mole of acid needs 1 mole of base. I should say 1 mole of HCl needs 1 mole of sodium hydroxide to completely neutralize. Also, we know that molarity of any substance is equals to number of moles divided by volume, and this volume must be in liters. Now imagine that we have an acid, some volume of acid, maybe 0.5 liter of acid. Let's say this acid is HCl, and its concentration or molarity is unknown. So we have no clue what its molarity is. So the way to figure out its molarity is, we already know the volume of this acid because we can measure the volume. We can transfer this acid to any measuring cylinder and we can measure the volume. It could be other than 0.5 liter also. Any volume will work. All we need to do is we need to add a known base such as sodium hydroxide whose molarity is known. So this is the condition. So molarity of the base should be known. So for example, in this case, let's say molarity is 1.00 moles per liter, right? So that's the molarity of our known sodium hydroxide. Then what we need to do is we need to add this base until it completely neutralizes it. So the way we conduct it, so we add using a instrument. This instrument is known as burette. So burette has a scale on the side. So we fill this burette up with the base. So that's zero here. And we keep, so there's a nozzle here, there's a valve here. So we open the valve and we start adding the base into it. So in the beginning, small quantity of base is added, it will neutralize some of the acid. And we keep adding the base until all the acid is neutralized. So once the acid is completely neutralized, we stop this addition. Now you may ask, how do we know that acid is neutralized? Okay, so to know how the acid is neutralized, we add a substance, we call it an indicator. The purpose of indicator is it changes the color of solution once the acid is neutralized. So in this sodium hydroxide and HCl experiment, we add an indicator named phenolphthalein. So phenolphthalein, it makes the solution pink once the acid is neutralized. So from the color change, we'll know that the acid is neutralized. So what happens is that we started the NaOH at 0 mL, and then we added it maybe once the reaction was completely done, now maybe we added 23.5 mL. Okay, so now we know that in order to completely neutralize this base, we added this much, excuse me, in order to completely neutralize our acid, whose molarity is unknown, we added 23.5 mL base. So 23.5 mL sodium hydroxide was used to completely neutralize the acid. Once we figure out the volume of the base which is needed to completely neutralize the acid, then our experiment is done. Rest is the calculation. It's a simple calculation, and we can figure out the concentration of the or the molarity of this unknown molarity of our HCl. All we need is this formula. We know molarity is equal to moles over volume. Now for HCl, we don't know the molarity, right? So we don't know the moles, but volume we do know. So volume of acid, which is HCl, we already know. So in this case, is 0.5 liter. Right, so this is known. We don't know the molarity, we don't know the moles yet. Okay, so how about the base? So volume of base used in the neutralization reaction. We conducted the experiment and we know that the base which was used was 0 to 23.5. So it means total volume used was 23.5 milliliter, right? So it's milliliter. So first thing we need to do is we need to convert this milliliters to liters, because acid is in liters, so we should convert this also into liters, right? So in order to convert into liters, we'll use this conversion factor. So we already know that 1 liter contains 1,000 milliliters, so milliliters and milliliter cancel, so it comes out to be 0.0235 liters. Okay, so we know the mole volume of base in liters. Do we know the molarity of base? That is also known. Molarity of base, we said it's 1.00 moles per liter. So this molarity will be known to us, will be given to us in the experiment also. So let's say 1.00 moles over liter. Now, as stated earlier, molarity is equals to moles divided by volume, and volume must be in liter. So we know the molarity of base, we know the volume of base. Can we calculate the moles of base? The answer is yes, because we can reshuffle this equation. So this equation, when we multiply volume on both sides, so moles will be equals to molarity multiplied by volume, right? So moles is equals to molarity times volume. We already know the molarity, so that's 1.00 moles over liter multiplied by the volume. Volume we calculated is 0.0235 liters. So now liters cancel with liters, and from this we can calculate the moles. So moles comes out to be, so moles of NaOH is equals to multiply 1 times 0.02. It will be same as So that many moles. So now we know the moles of NaOH. And from the balance equation, we know that in a neutralization reaction, moles of NaOH is same as moles of HCl because it's 1:1 reaction. So in this reaction, if we are using these many moles, so moles of HCl will also be same. So therefore, moles of HCl is equals to same as moles of NaOH. And we already know the moles of NaOH. So therefore, moles of HCl is also gonna be 0.0235 moles. That's for this example. In your experiment, you will come up with some different number. Now we know the moles of HCl, and we already know the volume of HCl. So using these two values, volume and moles, can we calculate the molarity of HCl? So we already know molarity is equals to moles divided by volume, right? So mole we calculated here, volume we calculated here. So let's plug in the value. So 0.0235 moles divided by volume of 0.5 liters. And if we divide these two numbers, we should get our molarity of HCl, and molarity is the concentration. So this value comes out to be 0.47 moles over liter. So that is the molarity of HCl, and that is the entire titration experiment of acids and base. This same calculation can be applied to other acids and bases also, but HCl and NaOH are the most common ones. And that's the calculation. Okay, so let's go over the lab report. So before we go to the lab report, I would like to let you know that before we go over the lab report, please watch the video. In this video, they showed how the acid-base titration is done. And there is another video about using and reading a burette. So burette is the instrument by which we add the base into the acid during a titration experiment. And there is another video about calculation of pH or operating a pH meter. So pH meter is a device which is used to measure pH of any solution. So please watch these videos and then go to the lab report. I'll show you how to complete the lab report. So when you open the lab report, you will find this page, and in this page, it will ask you, are you completing this experiment online? You will choose yes. This is because we need experimental data to complete the report. As you know that we are not actually conducting the experiment, so we need the data. So click yes, and then click on request provisional data, and then confirm. Now the data is already given to you. So in part one of this experiment, we are measuring the pH value of various solutions. The solutions which are given to us are vinegar, ammonia, lemon juice, shampoo, detergent, hair conditioner, mouthwash, antacid, and aspirin. As you can see, these are things from our common daily life or household things. And we would like to know that whether these things are acids, bases, or neutral. And remember, if the pH of this solution is less than 7, then it's an acid. If it's more than 7, it's a base. If it's exactly 7, then it's neutral. So pH is measured with two different methods. First method is using a pH paper. So pH paper is a strip of a paper. You dip that paper strip in the solution, it will change color. And then there is a code and you match your color of the paper to that provided code, and you will note down the pH value depending on the color of the paper. And the second method is using a pH meter. So pH meter is just a digital meter. You have a probe, so you insert the probe in your solution and the meter will give you a reading. So our first solution is vinegar. pH using the pH meter paper value is 2, and if you measure pH using a pH meter, it's 2.8. So because the pH value of a vinegar is less than 7, so vinegar is acidic. Similarly, ammonia, its pH value using the paper strip is 12, and the pH value using pH meter is 11.8. It's much higher than 7, so hence ammonia is a base. So that's how you're gonna analyze the value of pH. In the second part, we are conducting experiment in which we added acid to various solutions, and we looked at the effect of acid to those solutions. So first one was water. In water, our initial pH was 5.7. Then we added 5 drops of acid and we measured its pH again. And you notice that the pH of water dropped. This is because acids have low pH, and any addition of acid to water will drop the pH. If we added 5 more drops, then the pH will drop even further. In the second solution, we did the same to 0.1 molar sodium chloride solution. Initial pH was 6.8. After adding 5 drops, pH went down, and when we added more drops of acid, pH went down further. So that happens usually to any solution. When you add acid, its pH will drop. Let's take a look at what happens to the pH of buffers when we added acid. So we have a high pH buffer. The initial pH value of buffer was 9.9. We added 5 drops of HCl. It remained about the same. Yes, there is a slight decrease in pH, but that's negligible compared to other solutions. And then we added 5 more drops, and the pH of buffer dropped to 9.3. As you can see, that more or less the pH of buffer remained constant even after adding 10 drops of acid. The effect will be much less for low pH buffer. Its initial pH value is 3.6, but after adding a few drops of acid, you can see that the pH didn't drop that much. So that's what happens to buffers. They they resist the change in pH after we add acids or bases. And similarly, we can see the effect of addition of base to the same 4 solutions. And finally, the data for acid-base titration is given. In this case, the acid is not HCl, it's acetic acid. Acetic acid is the acid found in vinegar, and the base is also NaOH. So brand of vinegar is given, volume of vinegar is 5 milliliter, and molarity of NaOH is also given. So that's the value of molarity, and the volume of NaOH, initial volume of NaOH was 0.53, and the final volume of NaOH was 44.66. So from 0.53 to 44.66, that's the amount of NaOH which was added to neutralize the acid. And the same experiment was done 3 times. Well, there's a typo, it should be trial 1 here. So that's a trial 1, and then trial 2, and finally trial 3. So now how are we gonna use this data? So first, we're going to calculate whether the solutions are acidic, basic, or neutral. I already explained how to do it. For example, vinegar, the pH values are 2 and 2.8, less than 7, so we will choose acidic, and so on. So you can complete. And in the second part, the buffer solution, that's when we noticed what happens to the pH of these solutions when we add acids. So first, water. The pH dropped from 5.3 to 2.6. So you write the pH change. So from the starting value to end value. So starting value was 5.3 and the end value is 2.2. So now we need to calculate the pH change. So the pH change would be 5.3 minus 2.2. So that value will come out to be 3.1. So we subtract it and we calculate. And in this case, buffer yes or no. So of course it's in no. Similarly, you can calculate if what's the value of a pH change and if it's a buffer yes or no. And finally, the acid base titration experiment. So in this experiment, there are three different trials. So it means that the acid-base neutralization reaction was done three times. Remember, the volume of acid used, vinegar was our acid, was 5.00 milliliters. So we will need to convert this into liters eventually. So initial volume is this much and final volume is this much. It means total volume added will be final minus initial. So in this case, we will subtract 44.66 minus 0.53, whatever value you obtain. So that's going to be the answer there. So that's the volume of NUH used. Okay. So you will get the volume three times. So for trial one, trial two, and trial three. And then from those three values, calculate the average volume of NUH used. So average is add all of these three values and then divide by three. So that's how you calculate the average. So this will give you the value of NUH in milliliters, and then convert this milliliters to liters and then write down that value here. And moles of NUH used, so moles of NUH used will be equals to let's say the average comes out to be some number. Let's call this number A. And okay, so I'm gonna write here. So let's say that this value is X. This value is okay. It's not gonna let me put these values. So average will be X. Make sure you put parentheses, so X plus Y plus Z divided by 3. So that's how you calculate the average. And then in liters, so imagine that this average comes out to be A. And then this liters will be A divided by 1000. So that will be the value in liters. Moles of NUH use, we know moles is equals to molarity multiplied by the volume. So molarity of NUH is given to us. So that's the value of molarity here. So moles will be equals to molarity multiplied by volume, of course, for NUH. So use this volume, the average volume. So that volume will go here. So moles of acetic acid, that will be same as moles of NaOH. So we just calculated the moles of NaOH, whatever value you get here, same value, because it's 1:1 reaction. So for every 1 mole you need, 1 mole of acid needs 1 mole of base. So therefore moles are same. And molarity is equals to, again, moles of acetic acid which is here. We calculated the moles here, so use this value divided by volume of acetic acid. So remember, volume of acetic acid is 5 milliliter given here, but we need to convert this milliliters to liters. So when you do convert this milliliters to liter, you will see the value is 0.005. So that's the value which you will get when you convert 5 milliliter to liters. So you will calculate the molarity here. Finally, you need to calculate the mass of acetic acid. So we already know the moles of acetic acid. We can use the mole to and the molar mass calculation formula to calculate the mass. The formula is given here. So this is the formula which you need to use to calculate the mass of acetic acid. So mass of acetic acid is moles of acetic acid, which we already know. So moles of acetic acid is here. So these are the moles, right? And then moles of acetic acid multiplied by 60 gram divided by 1. So this is the formula by which you can calculate the mass of acetic acid. Once you know the mass of acetic acid, you need to calculate the percentage concentration of acetic acid. Is mass by volume, so it is equals to mass of acetic acid, which we just calculated here, divided by the volume, and volume was 5 ml, right? So that's the formula, the mole percent. So mass divided by the volume. So here we don't need to use liters, we are going to use milliliters and multiply by 100. And that's how you calculate the percentage concentration of acetic acid. On the bottle, the percentage concentration is given to be 5%, and here experimentally we'll see how much we calculate. Technically it should be close to 5. We'll see what we get. So finally, in this experiment, again it's a similar titration experiment, but the values are given instead of the data which we did. So similar calculations are needed here, and you solve it and find the concentration of acetic acid in this case also.